Olive was wearing a red bobble hat and a green scarf and was standing on crunchy snow. There were lots of log cabins covered with sparkly decorations. Elves were running around carrying presents. Olive was admiring the decorations and wasn't looking where she was going. She collided with an elf who dropped all his presents.
Ouch! Watch out!
Complained the elf.
Sorry, I'm Olive. Let me help you pick those up.
Thanks, Olive. I'm Eric.
Why is everyone so busy, Eric?
It's almost Christmas, of course. Here at the North Pole, it's Santa's most busy time of the year.
Oh, who's Santa?
Hello, Santa Claus. Bright red suit, white beard. Ho, ho, ho. Really? On Christmas Eve, he delivers presents on his flying reindeer sleigh to children all around the world.
Well, that does sound impressive.
Yeah, it is. Anyway, I got a dash.
Olive walked past a big log cabin. Inside, she could see two elves polishing a sleigh.
That must be Santa's flying sleigh.
There was a barn next door to the garage.
And the reindeer must live there.
Olive heard groans coming from the barn.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
She went inside to investigate. In one of the stalls, Olive spotted a reindeer.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
Groaned the reindeer. She didn't look very well.
Hello, I'm Olive. Are you okay?
I'm Dancer, and I'm feeling really poorly. If I don't get better soon, I won't be able to pull Santa's flying sleigh with the other reindeer. He'll be one short.
Well, maybe there's some way I can help.
Well, there is a magical reindeer potion that might work, but someone would have to travel all over the world super fast to find all the ingredients.
A magical potion, a flying sleigh. I think I may have an idea. Dancer, will Santa let me borrow his sleigh? Maybe I can go and find the potion ingredients.
Oh, sorry, no one drives Santa's sleigh apart from Santa. But you could always borrow his flying motorbike instead.
Flying motorbike?
Olive looked out of the window and spotted a red and white motorbike with wings.
Here's a list of the ingredients. Be careful, Olive.
Dancer, I won't let you down.
So Olive climbed onto Santa's motorbike. Suddenly it flew up into the sky.
Well, okay, first ingredient. Chestnuts from the Queen's garden. I think I know where to find those.
Olive landed in a garden where she found the Queen's gardener, Frank McBadger.
Hello there, Olive.
Hello, Frank. Could you give me some chestnuts, please? It's for a potion to help one of Santa's reindeer get well.
Ah, of course. Here's a few I picked today.
Frank gave Olive some shiny red chestnuts.
Thanks very much. Next on the list, some tennis rackets.
Olive landed on a tennis court where she found top tennis player John McIntoad.
You cannot be serious. It's my old buddy Olive.
Hi, John. Can I have some tennis rackets, please? It's a Christmas emergency.
Sure. Here you go. Hey, want to stay for a game?
Sorry, mustache. Next ingredient for the potion, fur from a yeti.
Olive landed on Mount Everest, where she found a yeti.
Hello, Mr. Yeti. Could I have some of your fur, please? I'm on a mission from Santa.
The yeti pulled out lots of his blue fur and gave it to Olive.
Thanks very much. Of course, I'll make sure you get a nice present from Santa. Next ingredient, a tail feather from a cheeky parrot.
Olive landed in the jungle where she found a cheeky parrot.
Excuse me, please can I borrow a tail feather?
Excuse me, please can I borrow a tail feather?
Olive plucked a feather from the parrot's tail.
Oh, ouch!
Thanks. You may have saved Christmas.
Thanks. You may have saved Christmas.
All right, all right. Final ingredient, smelly socks.
Olive landed in Dudley Sud's laundrette.
Oh, hello, Olive.
Hi, Dudley. Please could I have some smelly socks? It's to make a reindeer feel better.
Oh, no problem. Lots of those around here.
Thanks, Dudley.
See ya.
Olive now had all the ingredients and she zoomed back towards the North Pole. But as she sped along, the parrot feather fell off the motorbike and dropped into the clouds below.
Where's it gone?
But there was no time to find the feather. Olive had to get back. Olive quickly took all the ingredients inside the reindeer barn. Dancer had a big pot of water waiting.
Did you find everything, Olive?
I did, but I dropped the parrot feather.
Oh, no, it's almost time for the sleigh to leave. We could try an ostrich feather instead.
That just might work.
Olive put some chestnuts, Yeti fur, tennis rackets and smelly socks into the pot, then plucked one of her own tail feathers and dropped that in too. Dancer sprinkled over some magic dust, making it safe to drink. The pot steamed and fizzled. Then Olive poured some potion into a mug and gave it to Dancer.
Thanks, Olive. Oh, that tastes horrible.
Olive and Dancer waited, but Dancer wasn't feeling any better.
Oh, I don't think the potion is working.
Well, I guess an ostrich feather isn't quite the same.
Oh no, those bells means the sleigh is about to leave.
Olive looked outside. The other seven reindeer were ready in front of the sleigh, which was now piled high with presents.
Santa will be here any second.
Olive noticed there were still some ingredients left over.
A poorly reindeer, some potion ingredients. I think I may have another idea.
Olive quickly disguised herself as a reindeer, using the leftover ingredients.
I'll pretend to be you, Dancer. Santa will never know.
Well, it's worth a try.
Just then, Santa Claus himself appeared.
Ho, ho, ho! I see all my reindeer already.
Olive's disguise had worked. Santa sprinkled some magic flying dust over everyone. He climbed onto the sleigh and they all flew off.
Yay! I'm a flying ostrich! Reindeer!
So Olive and Santa and the reindeer delivered presents all round the world.
Ho, 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 away we go, flying through the sky.
Ho, 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 through the snow, and if you're still awake, you'll see us flying by.
It's Christmas Eve, and all the children should be fast asleep. I'll pop down the chimney, and I promise not to make a peep. If you hear hooves on the icy roofs, it's only Santa's sleigh. In the blink of an eye, I'll eat a mince pie, and then I'll be on my way. Through the night, what a sight, racing round the world. Whizzing past, lightning fast, delivering the toys to all the boys and girls.
Snow, and if you're still awake, you'll see us flying by.
So I say ho, 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 ho.
When they got back to the North Pole, it was Christmas Day. But Santa's final landing was bumpy, and Olive's disguise fell off.
Oh, what's this? There's been an ostrich pulling my sleigh.
Boomed Santa.
Sorry, Santa. I'm Olive. I'm only helping because Dancer was poorly.
Oh, well, I didn't know. In that case, thank you, Olive. We must go and see how Dancer is feeling.
It turns out I was going to have some babies. That's why I felt unwell.
Well, I never. Let's celebrate with a huge Christmas dinner. Olive, would you like to join us?
Cake? I'd love to. But I need to get home to my family too.
They all laughed. And as they did, Olive realised it was time to go.
Typical Olive, daydreaming again,
said her mum.
What the heck? Actually, I've been helping pull Santa's sleigh.
Your head's been in the sand too long, dear,
said Olive's dad. Her little brother laughed. But Olive wasn't listening. She was already dreaming of her next big adventure.